South Sudan is the world's youngest country, but on the eve of its third birthday, conflict is tearing it apart. Over 1.5 million people have fled their homes since fighting erupted in 2013. And as entire towns and villages have come under attack, medical care has also come into the firing line. Malakal Teaching Hospital in Upper Nile State, MSF was responding to an outbreak of a deadly disease called Kalarazar. It's spread by the sandfly and is fatal if left untreated. When the conflict started, MSF also provided emergency treatment to victims of violence. On February 22, 2014, MSF teams returned to the hospital after heavy fighting had forced them to temporarily withdraw. They found 14 dead bodies in the hospital compound, but this wasn't the result of Kalarazar. It was the result of a brutal attack on the hospital. In amongst the patients too weak to flee for safety, 11 patients had been shot dead whilst lying in their beds.
You know, they used to come, 10 or 5 or 15, they come in there with gun. They're telling people, your mobile, your money, your what, if we don't give, they just shoot you. All of us, in all words. They're in that hospital. And some of them are shot. And even they took some girls and some women. They took it. Where they are now, we don't know.
Lo más estudiante era ver que había pacientes en sus camas que compartían habitación con algunos de los cadáveres durante varios días sin tener ningún tipo de asistencia médica. Todo estaba revuelto, tirado por los suelos, era irreconocible como un hospital.
MSF evacuated several of the most severely ill patients to a UN base for treatment. 13 gunshot victims. MSF has a long history of working in Malakal. Despite temporary evacuations, MSF have continued to treat patients throughout the fighting. But after the February attacks, the hospital lies empty. MSF is working in a UN-protected base, but without the facilities it had before the conflict. The threat of violence is never far away, and MSF is desperately worried about the people who remain cut off from healthcare. The attack on Malakal Teaching Hospital was not an isolated incident. Only a few weeks earlier, an MSF hospital was completely destroyed.
No vomiting last night, but vomiting before she came in.
Leia Hospital was one of MSF's longest running projects. The hospital where MSF had worked for 25 years provided a critical lifeline for 270,000 people in the surrounding area.
So this is our inpatient department. We treat patients for various reasons. Brucellosis, pneumonia, Kalarazar. But we get so many patients here that we can't just contain them to the ward inside like you would normally at home.
It was also the only hospital in the area where people could receive inpatient care. But following weeks of insecurity, at the end of January, 240 of MSF's South Sudanese staff were forced to evacuate Leia Hospital. They fled into the bush, taking dozens of severely injured patients with them as they went.
This was, I think, a very difficult time for all of us. We feel powerless in regard to such kind of situation. We feel powerless as well when it comes to this hospital that we've been running and building over the last 25 years. And it got completely burned and destroyed despite all our messages and contact with the different parties in the conflict.
Weeks later, as the fighting calmed, MSF teams returned to discover an horrific scene. Buildings had been reduced to ash, equipment had been smashed, and drugs and other supplies strewn throughout the hospital grounds. But the scenes in Leia and Malakal are only part of the picture. MSF has recorded a number of other incidents. People across South Sudan count on MSF and others for critical medical care. But medical care has come under fire in South Sudan. Rather than safe havens for treatment, medical facilities have at times become targets of attack. But when hospitals are destroyed and staff and patients are attacked, it's people in need of healthcare who suffer the most.